it's Carly McAvoy, talking about volume and surface area of three-dimensional objects, and where this video is about a cylinder. The volume of a cylinder formula is pi r squared h. Notice that this formula contains the formula for the area of a circle, which is pi r squared. So we're really just looking at an area of a circle and then multiplied by the height of that. So that gives us a three-dimensional object. And remember, when we talk about volume, it's expressed as cubic units because there's three dimensions. So the volume of a cylinder with a diameter of 6 2/5 inches and a height of 3.5. Well, first of all, we would have to change this into a radius because our formula is radius squared. So we can use a calculator to do that. You might be able to see that this is going to be 32/5. And you might be able to do that in your head now that you've practiced doing that. What is half of that, or divided by 2, should be 16/5, right? So our radius is 16/5. And our height is 6 7/2. And I'm going to use for pi, what I was finding when I was using the computer program is that they did not like 3.14. So you have to either use the pi button on your calculator or just go a little further out. I'm going to use the pi button on my calculator, which most calculators have. So our volume is going to be pi and then radius, which is 16/5 squared, and then height, which is 7/2. Notice I'm just using the numbers as given. If you have a calculator, why not, right? So let's put that in then. I have pi. My calculator has a pi button right here, and you just push it once, and it gives you the, whoops. I want to clear that. Pi, nope. I want to put in pi after that. Okay, so I have 16/5, and then I want to square that times pi times 7/2, and that gives me this number. Now I want a decimal number. I don't want that weird kind of fraction, so I'm going to change that into that. Down here near the bottom of my calculator, I have a fraction to decimal button, and most of you will have something like that. So I'm going to hit second, fraction to decimal, and then hit enter. And what I get when I do that, you can see I hit that fraction to decimal button and I got this answer. And I'm going to say approximately, because once you use pi, that's an approximation. It's not exact. Depending on where they ask us to go with this, let's say they ask us to go to the hundredths, I could say 112.59. And what's the units going to be? Well, we started off with inches, and that's going to be cubic inches, because it's three-dimensional. Okay, so if you don't get a, if I had gone like this, if I had started with an approximation for pi, by the way, is 3.14159. That's a pretty good one. That gets you a pretty solid answer usually. 3.14, I can say it, can't put it in. And then times 16/5 squared, which I could change that into a decimal as well, but squared, where's my squared button, there it is, and then times 7/2. I can push the fraction button before I start to enter the fraction or after, but if I had entered it as a fraction to start with like that, it would have just given me that almost exact same answer. You can see that the numbers are different after the first three, because the approximation for pi that I use is probably a little shorter than the approximation that the calculator has programmed in. Anyway, our volume is about 112.59 inches cubed, okay? And that is with a radius of 16/5, because they gave us the diameter. Okay, I think you can plug into that formula pretty well. When we talk about the surface area of a cylinder, it looks pretty scary at first, 2 pi rh, plus 2 pi, oops, that didn't come out. Don't know why that little r squared didn't come out. This formula includes two circles from either end of the cylinder. So we have a circle at the bottom, which is pi r squared, and we have a circle at the top, which is pi r squared, and that's where that 2 is, 2 pi r squared. This formula, if you are asked to find the lateral surface of the cylinder, then the two ends are not included, and then you would just be looking at this round part. Why would you ever want to know just the lateral? Well, maybe you were going to build a grain silo, and you want to know how much metal you needed to draw that to make that. Well, you would probably have a concrete slab, so you wouldn't have metal on the bottom, maybe. And then you might have some kind of roof on the top that would be different than the materials on the outside. So lateral surface area would be all that you'd be concerned with, and you're buying the materials for that. Or if you were going to build a trash can, you'd have the bottom, but you wouldn't have the top. So it's kind of nice to see that the lateral surface area is just the 2 pi RH, and it doesn't include that the two bases. And the circumference of a circle is 2 pi r. So that's already in there as well. So we're talking about, when we talk about that lateral surface area, we're talking about the circumference of the circle times the height of the circle. And if we look at this diagram that I have here, when you talk about this, the height of the, if you laid your circle out flat like this, you could see you have the top and the bottom, which are the 2 pi r squared parts. And then that's these two parts. And then here you have 2 pi r, which would be the circumference of that circle if you were looking at going around the original circle. Sorry, you can't, it's off the screen. But that would be the circumference of that circle, 2 pi r, or sometimes you say diameter times pi, and maybe that's even too small for you to read. 2 pi r, or it could be diameter times pi, but 2 radius is a diameter, right? So that's kind of what we're talking about. So that's where we get that formula. It's just a rectangle when you lay it out flat, and it's 2 pi r on this side and h going up this side. And so that's where we get the 2 pi r h. So in this one, we're asked to find the surface area and the lateral surface area of a cylinder with a height of 12 and a diameter of 44. So for the surface area, we have 2 times pi times radius. Well, the diameter is 44, and half of 44 is 22. And then h is, 12. And then we have 2 pi times the radius, which is 22 squared. Just ran off the page there. So that part is squared. Okay, so we just have to calculate that. And again, I'm going to use my calculator. The surface area is, and I'm going to use 3.141459 just so we get the decimal in here, 2 times 3.141459 times 22 times 12. And that part is 1,658.7595. I'm not gonna round that off yet. I did round it, but I went out 4 places. And the second part, 2 pi r squared, is 2 times 3.14159 times 22 squared. That part is 3,041.0591. And if I add that together with the 1,658.7595 that I already had from the first part, I get a surface area of 4,699. And now I'm going to round to the hundredths, to 82. And just read the directions. It might ask you to round to the hundredths, or it might ask you to round to the tenths or whatever. So, now I want to figure out what my units are. Well, it started off with feet, and I did a surface area. Now, when we talked about volume, it was to the third power because it's three-dimensional. Look at our picture of what we're doing here. This is a flat object. It's two-dimensional. So it's two-dimensional. It's got a length and a width. There's no height to that once we flatten it out. So every time we're talking about surface area, we're just talking about feet squared. Okay, then the lateral surface area, well, there's a reason that I wrote this out, right? The lateral surface area is just that first part of that first formula, which I already know was 2 pi 22 times 12. That is 2 pi RH. And so if I did that correctly before, I don't need to do that again. And I'm going to round that off to two places and call that 7, 6. And again, that's an area. All area problems are always square feet. So we have the surface area and the lateral surface area and the volume of a cylinder. All right, have a great day, and I'll see you next time.